We have a topic here about lessons for human from other living things. When we are in the school, when we learn about the science, there is a subject there called biology. And in the biology, they teach us that there are living things and there are non-living things. What are the living things? Human beings, animals, the plants. And what are the non-living things like sky, the stars, or planets, or other things? Like buildings could be also non-living things. So our subject here is about the living things. Human need to get the lessons from the non-living things, other living things. So what are the other living things beside the human beings? Are the animals, the birds, the plants, the trees. There also could be also other living things as angels or jinn, but we are not going to talk about angels and jinn. We are only talking about what lessons we human can get from animals, the birds, and the plants. What are the lessons we can get from them? Because Allah is teaching us in the Quran and also in the Hadith of the Prophet Muhammad, we learn so many good examples. In fact, when we read the Surah Fatiha, and the next to the Surah Fatiha, the Surah, which starts with Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim Alif Lam Mim Dhalika al-Kitab al-Raiba Fihi Hudal lil-Muttaqin. We ask in Surah Fatiha the guidance, and Allah is teaching the guidance in Surah Baqarah. He said, Alif Lam Mim Dhalika al-Kitab al-Raiba Fihi Hudal lil-Muttaqin. We ask Ihdinas Surat al-Mustaqim, answer in the Surah Baqarah, Dhalika al-Kitab al-Raiba Fihi Hudal lil-Muttaqin. That is the book, no doubt in it, guidance for those who are Muttaqin. When the first time the Ustad came, he talked about taqwa, very beautiful message, that taqwa is that you fear Allah, so you follow His commandments, and you don't do what is haram. Perfect definition. And taqwa actually, because in Tagalog there are many Arabic words. You can so many Arabic words similar to Arabic words in Tagalog. Like taqwa is, in Tagalog is takut. So similar taqwa, takut. Parang Arabic yung takut. Similar to taqwa, afraid. But afraid is not that you're afraid and you're shivering or afraid meaning to Allah that you will not disobey Him. You're not going to disobey Allah, that's meaning afraid. Okay, Allah said pray, so I will pray because I'm afraid to Allah. Allah said don't eat haram, I'm afraid to Allah, I will not eat haram. Allah said wake up for Fajr, I will wake up because I have a taqwa, takut ako sa Allah. So I will do it what Allah command me. Because if I will not do it, Allah will angry. As being a father, I can feel very bad when my children will not obey me. So Allah is the Lord. He is more bigger than anyone else. He is the Lord. He is the Creator. He is the Master. He is the Supreme. He is the King. And when his slave, yung alipin niya, ayaw niyang sunusakan sa utos niya, galit siya. He's angry. But if you follow Him, He loves you very much. Like when our children obey us, we love them very much. We feel very happy that my children are following me. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran in Surah Baqarah. This is the first surah. Remember this. Surah Fatiha, the opening chapter, in which is all the essence of the Quran. And in first surah. What is the next surah after Surah Fatiha? What is the next surah after Surah Fatiha? Baqarah. Subhanallah. Allah make the name of the surah Baqarah. What is Baqarah? Our topic here. Lesson from the living things. Animals. What is Baqarah? Cow. Baka. Subhanallah. Imagine this. Why Allah is giving the first chapter name is Baqarah? Because He wants to give us a lesson that Baqara, the Baka or the cow, even Baqara similar to Baka. Baqara, Baka, sa Tagalog, Baka, parang Baqara. Okay, so I said that Tagalog, because dati, wala pang Spanish, the Philippine was Marlika. And Salita is like Arabic, Alibata. So Philippine dati yung salita ng Philippine alif bata, parang Arabic. So Allah is making the first chapter of the Quran Bakara. Why is making Bakara? Because Bakara is a cow, and cow is a very, very good animal. What is the number one meat? Yung karne, galing sa cow. Number one meat, beef. All the world, number one karne, number one meat, beef. Beside water, the number one drink sa all mundo, sa all the world, number one drink, milk. Saan galing milk? Number one, from the cow. And the best clothes, yung ano pinakamaganda ng damit? What is the best cloth in the world? The best food, beef, galing sa cow. The best drink, milk, from the cow. And the best clothes, what is the best clothes? Leather. And where is the best leather come from? Cow, subhanallah. So Allah is teaching that, look at this cow, it is beneficial to the humankind. You as a human should be beneficial to the humankind. When the cow can be beneficial to humankind, we humans should be beneficial to humankind. That's the number one lesson. Because Allah wants us to follow the way of the cow, that how this cow giving her life to be good for the people, to beneficial for the people. You eat the cow, you drink the cow, you wear the cow, subhanallah, complete. That your food from the cow, your drink from the cow, and your clothes, the best clothes, leather, where it come from? From the cow. So Allah is teaching us that you get the lesson from the cow, how this cow give all the life for the sake of Allah to serve the people, to good with the people. That's why Allah is putting the first surah after surah Fatiha, first surah Baqarah. He's telling us, look at this cow. It's an example for you that how much this cow is giving benefits to the mankind. You must do the same. The cow is not a human, but he's giving benefit to us. How much more human will give benefit to other human? How much more? Allah is commanding us to be good with the people. The one of the greatest commandments in the Quran, وَإِذَا قَدْنَا مِيسَاكَ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ لَا تَعْبُدُونَ إِلَّا اللَّهَ. First commandment, don't worship except Allah. وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Be good with your parents. وَذِي الْقُرْبَى وَالْيَتَامَى وَالْمَسَاكِينَ. And what is the commandment? وَقُولُوا لِلنَّاسِ حُسْنًا. Speak to the man, to the people, to the human beings, very good. Allah is commanding. One of the greatest commandment of Allah, magsalita na sa tao, mabuti. You speak to the people, very good. Which animal is the worst kind of sound Allah mentioned? Ano yung pinakamasama ng salita? Donkey. Allah Quran in the Quran, the donkey, you himar, ass. The worst kind of sound because it's shouting very badly. So we are commanded to speak good to the people, even if it is Muslim, Christian, Hindu, Buddhist, atheist, American, Chinese, Japanese, whatever people in the world, we speak good to the people. It is a command of Allah. Utus nag Allah. Don't be like a donkey, but be talk like a bird, like Hudhud. We speak like a beautiful, like the bird, very nice sound talking to the people. Be like a bird, to talk like a bird. The bird is talking very nicely. They are singing very nicely. So number one example for today's lecture is the cow. Cow is a very good animal that Allah put after Surah Fatiha. Allah gave the first surah name Baqarah to emphasize that why Allah liked this animal and he put in his book in the starting, because he wants to example for us that the cow is an animal, is not a human, but he is giving benefit to the human. Allah is teaching us, subhanallah. He is teaching us to be like a cow. To be like this animal which is giving the benefits to whole mankind. Every day you eat billions of kilos of beef. Every day we drink the billions of liters of milk. And the millions of tons of leather, the kilograms, the pieces, leather jacket, wallet, bags. Everything is made from the leather of the cow. And not only that, there are so many other things. You get the whey protein from the protein shake for your muscles. Where it come from? Cow. Medications come from cow. So Allah is giving us a lesson from the cow that this cow is doing a beneficial work for the human being. You should do the same. One of the example in the Quran, in the Hadith, Allah mentioned about the lion. Lion called in Arabic Asad. And lion is an example of, what is the example of the lion? It's an example of bravery, courage. Hindi duak. So Allah is teaching us through the lion, be like a lion, don't be like a coward. Don't fear people, but fear Allah. Takut ka sa Allah lang. Takut ka lang sa Allah. Wag ka takut sa maliban kay Allah. So lion is a good example to not to fear people, but to fear Allah. Takut ka sa Allah lang. Don't fear people, but fear Allah. So it's a good example. But at the same time, the lion can be a bad example also. Because lion is a beast. Kinakain ng tao. Destroying the people. So we can get the good example from the cow. It is very good example of brave. Hindi siya duwag, hindi siya coward. So we need to not to be coward, because to be coward, it's very hateful in Islam. Which animal in the whole the world, which animal teaches us our loyalty? Which animal is teaching us the loyalty in the whole Quran? If you talk about the loyalty, the best animal in the Quran, mentioned in the Hadith, is a dog. Dog is not betraying his boss. He's always be loyal to his boss. Sometimes some people, you do everything good, but they still betray you, your staff. But dog will not do this. Dog is a very good example of loyalty. Sometimes if the boss died, the dog will cry also. What is a traitor, trador? Yung dog is the pinakang loyal sa lahat ng hayop. Pinaka loyal sa lahat ng hayop, aso, dog. Sino yung baliktad? Yung trador. Sino yung trador sa pinagang trador sa all the animals? Number one traitor. Ahas. Okay, the snake. Don't be like a snake. Ano gagawin ng snake? Ahas. If you have attitude like ahas, it's very bad. You will go to hellfire. What is ahas? You get the milk. And give to the milk every day. Very nice milk. High quality milk. You put pa ano? Honey. Sugar pa. And then give to milk. Drink. Anong ginong produce niya? What he will produce? Be dog, not to be ahas, not to be a snake. You know, this yesterday I heard a video clip, very beautiful. Sabi niya, the baka, the cow, drink, eat the damo. Malinis ba yung damo kain ng malinis ba? May marumi dun. Siyempre marumi. Diba? Dahil may alikabok, diba? So lahat ng damo may marumi. Kain ng yung baka, the cow is eating grass. Kain ng baka yung damo. May marumi kunti, di ba? Okay. Yung tubig, mineral water ba inom niya? Hindi. Hindi malinis yung tubig din. Okay. Ano produce niya? Malinis na gatas. Healthy. Okay. So you are giving to the cow the grass with some dirt and water not clean, but is giving the pure milk. And you are giving to the ahas clean milk, everything clean, but produce niya poison. So I'll say in English. The cow, you give the grass and water not clean, with some dust, with some soil, not clean water, with some germs maybe, but when cow drink it and eat, will produce the pure milk. Pure milk. But the ahas, the ugali niya, you give him the clean milk, sweet milk, healthy thing, everything, but produce ahas. What the produce is snake? Poison. And will never be loyal with you, laging siya trador. He's always traitor to you. So Allah is giving us this here two examples. The dog is an example of loyalty, and the snake is an example of traitor. Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, you munafiq, you hypocrite, three signs. Whenever he speak the lie. Whenever you he promise, he breaks his promise. And whenever he trust you, you trust him, he will betray you. So betrayer, yung ahas, yung ugali mo parang ahas, you have a sign ng munafiq. Don't betray. Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam say, who cheat, he is not among us. He hindi siya Muslim. Because ugali niya cheating. So be honest, not to be traitor. We have so many examples in the animals and also for the plants, which we can discuss it for several meetings. But I'll try my best to give some examples, inshallah, which will be very beneficial that we can share with others also, because these examples are really intended for us by Allah to follow. It's very, very important us to follow those examples. For example, if you can get example like a wolf. The wolf is also an example of bravery. Because in this shot, takut. Kahit sa lion, he will fight. Okay? So, what is the loving example for the animals? Which animal is very loving and which is liked by the Prophet also? Prophet Muhammad, he liked that animal and that is a cat. The cat is an animal which is very, very loving animal and it has a very good attitude in some manner. We have example of monkey. It's also deception and it has also some intelligence also. We have example of fox also. We have example of sheep. We have so many examples which we need the lots of time to discuss, but I'm going to choose very important one, inshallah, to you to listen and to forward to others, inshallah, so that everybody can get benefit for this. Just give me a moment, please. So we have an example of cat. The cat is loving animal. Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam liked the cat. And dog is not actually dislike in Islam. Some people they say the dog is dislike and you must hate the dog. It is wrong teaching. When you open the Quran and when you go to the Surah Kahf, everybody knows Surah Kahf, correct? What happened in Surah Kahf? The people who wanted to save their iman, they hide in the cave, in the Kahf, in the ghar, and then they were put in the sleep by Allah for 300 years. And if the lunar calendar, that is 309 years. So during the sleep, what happened? Anybody can go inside and destroy you, then kill you, correct? So what Allah did? Allah put the dog in the door. Say entrance ng ghar, in the cave. The dog was there, Allah said in the Quran. The dog was on the entrance. The Ashabi Kahf, the people of the cave, were sleeping for 300 years. But the dog was making guarding. He was a security guard there. Allah said in the Quran that the people of the cave were sleeping in the cave, but the dog was on the door watching them. Actually, he was sleeping also, but people can thought that he is a guard there. So we should not think. So every time people pass, they run away. Takut, because they see the dog on the, he's sitting, he's not lying down, he's sitting down. But sleeping, but sitting down. The people say, oh, it's dangerous. Run away. Takut. So the dog has a very beneficial attitude of guarding. If you have you keep the dog can guard you, but it is not allowed to keep inside the houses. It's a medical reason because it can cause rabies, it can cause allergic, it can cause asthma. So it is a medical reason that Prophet ﷺ discouraged. But if you are using it in the farms, in the farmhouses or in open area in the province, then no problem as long as your reason is for security. So it's also example for us to protect other human beings. We should protect the other human beings to be harmed. And this sixth example, we also getting it from the dogs. And the cat has a very good attitude that it is a very shameful animal. Nahi Asha. Because usually the cat, when they defecate, they don't like to leave it like this. They want to dig it, they want to hide it. Subhanallah, you go to sometime public toilet? Public toilet. So example, you go to the bus station. And you go to public toilet, wala na flush. Hindi nagamit ng flush. Tao, ayaw ng flush. Gusto na kita ng tao yung marumi niya. But the cat will not do this. Usually. Unless if they have no soft soil, they might do it on out. But usually, the ugali ng, the character of the cat is to dig the hole and to put the dirt there. So very nahiya, very, very shy animal. And it's an example for a human being. It's a very shameful for the human to use the defecate and not to flush. And some people, like in the Philippines, they urine openly, publicly. Subhanallah. They stop the car middle of the road, they go down and urine, subhanallah. It is not right. It is not right to spread your urine on the tire, sa gulong at sa kalsada. Be learned from the cat. Cat not do this. They dig their dirt. They hide the dirt. We have another example here. Very, very beautiful example here is a horse. The Prophet ﷺ mentioned about the horse and he liked the horse. And riding the horse is a very good exercise. And the, what is the example of the horse? Horse is not lazy. Hindi siya tamad. Very active animal. So Allah wants us to be not lazy. Hindi tamad. Ayaw na Allah na yung tao ang tamad. Lazy. Sino yung pinakang lazy ng ano hayop? Who is the lazy animals? Who are the lazy animals? Himar. Donkey. You ask. Very, you don't have in Philippines, but if you go to Arabia or Pakistan, you will see the himar. The most lazy animal. Sino yung pinaka marumi ng hayop? The example of dirty. Don't be dirty because Allah don't like you to be dirty and Allah don't like you to eat dirty. Who is the dirtiest animal? Also lazy animal. Not only dirtiest, very lazy animal. Who is this? Pig. Kung may kita mo tao na sa Philippines, marumi damit niya, marumi katawan niya, marumi kwarto niya, anong sabi? Baboy ka. Dahil baboy ang marumi. The example of the baboy is dirty. This is a dirty example because the baboy, the pig, when somebody dirty, you call him a pig. Because the pig is Allah created as a garbage collector. The pig is the garbage collector. Because pig goes in the jungle, lahat na marumi kumakain niya. Para malinis yung jungle. So the pig is like a garbage collector. Allah did not create it for the eating, but to just to collect the garbage. That's why wherever the pig sees the dirty, will eat it. Even yung defecate niya, marumi niya, his own dirt, will eat by the pig. Because pig is commanded by Allah to eat dirt. And they have a very strong stomach to recycle the dirt. If other animal will eat dirt, they will die. Human will eat the dirt, will die also. So we have an example from the pig. Don't be like a pig, but be clean person. Now in the corona, everybody is cleaning. But we Muslim always clean. 5 times a day we make ablution. We wash our hands, our face, our arms, our feet. We always be clean. Every time, before eating, eat clean. After eat, finish it, clean. We learn to clean. We wash my face, we wash the nose, we wash the mouth, we make the miswak or the toothbrush. All the time we are commanded to be clean person. Allah said, Allah is loving the mutatahirin. Those who are cleanliness, Allah love them. Allah love to the mutatahirin. Those who are cleaning themselves, Allah love them very much. So don't be like a pig. Because pig is an example of a bad example of dirtiness. And then don't be lazy like a himar. And also the pig is very lazy. Tamatsya. Kaya ayaw niya nang yung ano. Always. And another big example is we have stopped before the retired general, Flor de Lisa. He is giving the example. When you see people are earning too much and they are not patient and they are angry, very fast he say, ugali niya baboy kain siya baboy kaya parang baboy siya. No patient. The pig has no patient. He sabi ni general, kung gutom si yung baboy, if the pig is hungry, eat. And if the children will come, say, go. Let me eat first. So it's a attitude of the pig is also very impatient. Sino yung pinaka-patient ng animal? The example, because Allah is giving his example to be patient. Who is the most patient animal? Sino yung pinaka-pasensya ng animal? Ayob. Huh? No. Cat is not patient animal. The most patient animal in the whole world is camel. The most patient animal. No one can compete with patientia. Not even human being. We are fasting only one day. Nighttime eating, early morning eating. The animal, the camel, will not eat and drink for 1 month. 1 month, no drink water. No water. You go in the desert, you're riding on the camel. Even you die, the camel will bring you. Will not die. Because 1 month, no drink water. The most patient animal Allah is giving, be like a camel. Don't be. Sometimes, gutom na ako, gutom na, subhanallah. No patient. You bring your staff, maybe Filipino, it's 12 o'clock, gutom na ako, gutom. Kain, subhanallah. No patient. Kain 12 o'clock, oh, I need to eat now. You wait, we just finished work. No, I am hungry, I need to eat now. So it's not good, you need to be patient. You're busy something, okay, eat later on, no problem. So patient, you learn from the camel. You need to listen for the patient. The most patient animal is camel. Very, very patient. Because they have a system, they have a blood, they have a vessels where they stock the water. And they use this on the top there. There are lots of fats which use for energy, so they will not eat. Not possible. You are 50 kg, then you carry 300 kg. Possible? Not possible. But for the ant, it's possible. You lung them. Kahit yung weight niya 1 gram, can carry 30 gram, 50 grams, subhanallah. Small ant and carrying very big object on the top of the back and going around. Pinakamasipag ng sa lahat ng mundo, ant. Pinakamasipag. The most efficient animal, the creation of Allah. Just an insect only. The ant can carry so much heavy things and they are very intelligent. They have you have a text message here nowadays, but the ant says messages for so many years. We have example of one of the great example we have, like we say the Baqara in the starting, the giving benefits. So in the animals, the most beneficial animal is cow. Who is the most beneficial animal to human being in the birds? And this is our example that we should be beneficial to human being. Which birds is giving the most benefits to mankind? Which birds? The most benefits given to the human being, a bird. Which bird? Chicken. The best example is the chicken. Subhanallah. You know how many billion chicken you slaughter? Every day, billions of chicken slaughter every day. We are 8 billion people and almost everybody eat chicken. So at least 1 billion chicken may be slaughter every day. A billion chicken slaughter every day. And they are giving their life to become our food. So it's another example for us that our life should not give harm to human being, but our life should give benefit to human being. And the number one example is, in the birds is chicken. In animal, number one example is cow. And the trees also. All the trees, they are giving us benefits. Either is palm tree, like coconut or the palm, or other palm trees, they are all beneficial. Other trees also, the fruit trees also, the plants, they are all beneficial. They are food for us, they are good stuff for stomach, they are giving us benefits through medication, herbs. Like guabano, like pomegranate, like apple. What the people said, one apple a day, all doctors away. Eat apple and get away from the doctors. No need to go to doctor because the fruits are beneficial. Vitamin C, all kind of vitamins and minerals are in the fruits and they are coming from the trees. And trees also in our topic is a living thing. So what that both the trees are doing, they give us a shadow, they give us a fruits, they give us the benefits, the medications. So it's another example that we human being, we should be beneficial to other human brethren. All the human beings are our brothers and sisters in humanity. And we should be the beneficial to them. And the most big benefit we can give to human being, to bring the words of Allah. Bring the words of Allah to them. We have another example is crocodile. Is it a good example? Crocodile, good example, bad example. And we have an idiom like one apple a day, we have an idiom for the crocodile, crocodile tears. Anong isabihin sa Tagalog? Luha ng buhaya. What is meaning? The crocodile, he's planned to you, he will looks very pitiful. When you are going in his trap, he will destroy you. So don't be a betrayer like crocodile. Don't be a traitor like the crocodile. Show yourself very pitiful, kawawa. And when somebody trusts you, you bite him. You kill him. So it's a very bad example to be like a crocodile. Not to be like an ahas, a snake. And don't be like a crocodile also. Because crocodile is always a bad example. And you can go on yourself. And now example, the monkey. Monkey is a very deceptive. Cheater. Monkey is a cheater. It's deceiving you. But yet the monkey has a one good attitude, matalino. Very intelligent. Imagine the monkey can copy you accurately. You do something, well, monkey will copy you right away. And I can tell you the very, very beautiful story I heard in the lecture. In India, there was some group of Muslims. They went there somewhere to live, somewhere in Delhi. And in the building, they have a food. All the monkeys come and they steal the food. Nakaw nila yung pagkain nila. Lagi araw-araw. And the people were very tired. Ano, what to do with this monkey? They get our food. They come to the house from the window. Kuha nila yung paano, nakaw nila lahat ng pagkain. They steal all the food. And these people were worried that how to deal with this monkey. So they decided to cook the bread and put the poison. Gawa sila ng yung tinapay, tapos lagi nila yung poison, lason. Yung tinapay na ano, yung bilog, Arabic bread, hoops. And they have many bread and they put on the rooftop. And they are hiding and seeing the monkey will come eat the bread and they die. So we have no more problem. So they put the poison and they're waiting for the monkeys to come. And they're hiding, tago nila. They're hiding and the people were hiding and the monkeys came. So many monkeys come, the young monkeys mostly. And they come. And they suspect. Yung araw-araw, tago yung pagkain. Ngayon, hindi tago. Bakit marami pagkain? So they suspect. May duda sila. That maybe there is some problem. So they did not eat. Because they're thinking, bakit marami yung tinapay? Yung araw-araw, tago yung pagkain. Ngayon, may tinapay na ready, anda. So they are not eating. They are getting the sinapai smell. Oh, problem. Something problem here. So they malis na. They go. Nobody eating. The people thinking, why this animal so intelligent? They know the poison. Okay. Just wait. Maybe they will come back. After 30 minutes or some time, all the monkey come back. But may dalawa pa matanda. Dala nila yung dalawa. They came all the monkey back and they bring two old monkeys. Lahat ng bumalik yung mga hunggoy at yung dalawa hunggoy na matanda pa, parang scholar. Parang PhD. And then they come there and the old monkey is sa likod, backside. And the two monkey, the old one, yung matanda tapos ganun-ganun. And they get the tinapay. Okay. And they talking to them. Then bumalik na. After some time, balik. They come back. All the monkey come back, but yung dalawa matanda, wala na. But all the monkey come back with the leaves, dahon. Dala nila dahon. They bring many leaves. They eat the leaves. They eat the bread, all. Kain sila lahat ng tinapay kasama yung dahon. Tapos na lahat. Hindi napatay, kahit isa. Bakit? Because they bring the leaves antidote. Because they know this has a poison and there is antidote. Because yung dalawa is color monkey. Sabi, you eat this bread with this leaves, dahon. So eat all the bread with the dahon. Wala na problem. You have more bread, bring more bread. We can eat all. So that's, imagine this animal, the monkey, is so intelligent. They make the solution for the bread. Kahit may lason kain, kasama yung dahon, hindi na patay. Hindi sila matay. So there's another intelligence here. This monkey, Allah make very intelligent. But they are cursed because they are very trador. They always betray. That's why you people of the Saturday, you Ashabu Sab sa Quran, when they're cheating to Allah, Allah said no fishing on Saturday because it's a worship day. They collect the fish on the butas, on the holes. And they collect the fish on Sunday. And say, oh, this Sunday fishing, no Saturday fishing. But Sabi the Prophet, that's a Saturday fishing. You are cheating Allah. But Allah know that. So what Allah make them? Monkey. Because monkey is a cheater. So Allah make these people monkey because monkey is a deceiver. We have an example of mosquito in the Quran. Quran is the example of mosquito. Is mosquito is a good example or a bad example? Bad example. Because what the mosquito does? Sucking your blood. It's like a bank. Parang pawn shop. The mosquito is the example is like a pawn shop, like a bank. They suck your blood. They get your money. They make you bankrupt. So don't be like a mosquito. Because mosquitoes, ugali ng mosquito, to sucking your blood. And imagine this small mosquito, no syringe. You don't feel any needle, but they'll get your blood. And the mosquito is a very, very harmful animal. World War I and World War II, how many people died? Maybe 100 million. Only for malaria in the 100 years, in Africa, more than 500 million people die in malaria. 500 million people die malaria from the mosquito. So mosquito is more people die, more than the World War I, World War II. Only in Africa, 500 million people died with the mosquito, with the malaria. So don't be an example of mosquito. It is very bad example. It is harmful to the mankind. And don't be like a rat. Don't be like a rat. What is the attitude of the rat? Hiding and cheating, deceiving. Will not be in the front. Will always make dirty also. It's a dirty example. It is example of deceiving, cheater, and this is example of coward. So many bad examples. The example of the rat is a very, very bad example. And there is another bad attitude of the rat, which I'll discuss in a while. If you go to the plant, which is also a living thing, we have a beautiful example of the plants of the flowers, giving good smell. So we should be like the flowers. When we go out, we should not be smelly, but we should have a good, very clean, like the flowers. We have example like the plants which giving you a good medications. So we should be helpful for the people to treat them with some good medicines, distributing the medicine to the people who cannot afford to buy the medicines. So it's another example that how we can treat people for their sicknesses. So many examples also beside the animals, we have so many good examples in the different kinds of plants. Different kinds of plants. You can even look the shape, for example. Now, I can give you the one of the example of the guayabano. The latest research said the guayabano, in English called soursop, soursop in English, but in Tagalog, they call it in Philippine guayabano. When you look at the shape of the guayabano, it's actually the anti-cancer. Any kind of cancer you can treat with guayabano. In Turkey, they are selling the drops made from guayabano, and that's curing the cancer. Anti-cancer, guayabano. And look at the shape of the guayabano, it looks like cancer. What Allah is saying, this is beneficial for you to cure your cancer. So guayabano is a plant coming from the plant which is beneficial for us for cancer. If you can check the walnuts, it's a walnut, is a the tree of the walnut is producing the walnut. What is look like the walnut? Did you see the walnuts? Walnuts. It's look like brain. And the modern science tell us when you eat the walnut, it can beneficial for your brain. So we have so many examples also in the plants and so many examples in the animals which we can follow, and the other example we should not follow. One of the bad examples is from the rat. I was hearing the lecturer named Imran Hussain. He said, I will tell you who is a man and who is a rat. Sino yung lalaki, sino yung daga. He said, the man is the one, when he has a wife, one, two, three, or four wives, he will not hide. No hiding wives, no mistress. But his wife, is, he will tell everybody, Aiba, one wife, two wives, three wives, four wives. How many wives? He will tell to the people. He is not like a rat to go hiding his wives. And what is the ugali here? In the creation, only one wife, but yung lahat iba kabit. Parang daga. Sila parang daga. They will go to the wife hidingly. Tago. So this is the example of a rat. So in Islam, it's open. When you marry, a man marrying, and he said, if he's kunkaya, if affordable, he can marry one, two, three, four, but not hidingly. Openly marriage with announcement. And everybody knows that how many wives he has. So this is a man. But here in the creation, only one wife and all, yung ibang babae, mistress lang. Tago, parang daga. Sila parang daga. They will hide their mistresses. Because in the creation, the man not allowed to have more than one wife, so they are doing illegal, haram. It is very big sin. So that's all, inshallah. We have some questions. It's 6:04 now. I have more example to speak, but it's enough for now, inshallah. We can have some questions to speak, if there are some questions, inshallah. And next time, we can have this kind of lecture in sometime again, inshallah, if Allah wills, inshallah, and can get more benefits for this kind of knowledge for us to follow, inshallah. So any example, any question, inshallah, you can ask me. Yes. Okay. Islam.
Ito po sa mosquitoes. Kasi po, madalas din po pinapangarap po yan ng ating mga mahomesis. Pagpag po ng mosquitoes na napakagandang halimbawa. Kaya nga lang po, yung sabi niya naman, bad na halimbawa doon sa nangyari po kasi nagmamalaria po yung kanilang
yes.
Nakakagandang. Ano po yun siya? Kasi po, tulad po yung hari po ng panahon po ni Propeta Ibrahim alayhis salam.
Yeah. Okay, that's the will of Allah. That's Allah did it, correct? So it's a will of Allah. But he's not only killing the Nimrud, the king. He's killing human being also. So you cannot call him a good example. Because the number one murderer for the human being is mosquito. Not lion, not the dog, or not the tiger, not wolf, not hyena, no. Who killed, not even human to human. The number one killer for the human being is mosquito. For the history, for the whole history. No one can kill more than you, mosquito. So mosquito is really an example of a murderer. It's a bad example. So don't be like a mosquito to kill innocent. Like example, when Ibrahim alayhi salam was burning in the fire, the pigeon, you know pigeon? Pigeon. Kalapati. What Kalapati did? Kalapati go and get water in the mouth and it started to put on fire. Pwede ba yung the fire can be extinguished? Hindi pwede, di ba? But the pigeon is trying to do. That's why the pigeon is a very lovable animal in Islam. We love the pigeons in Islam because it was trying to extinguish the fire of Ibrahim alayhi salam. But of course, this cannot be extinguished the fire, but still the pigeon is trying. So it's an example. When you see the evil, try to stop the evil. Even if it is not possible for you, but at least try, like the pigeon. So it's a good example also, the pigeon.